that tradition, that song, in my tradition, that song represents a god who is knowledge. That's our wisdom. That's where our wisdom and our ancestors come from. His name is Obatala. So I'm standing in class, and I'm trying to be a professional. But in my mind, this song is going. And so I stopped, and I thought, what does this mean? And what it reminded me of is exactly what we're talking about here. It reminded me of conversations that I've had with elders in this community, in the Black community here, who have been doing this anti-racism work and racial justice work for years, and who are looking to people like me and the young people that I work with at the university, wondering, when will the work stop? When will we celebrate? When will we be able to say that we have actually achieved racial justice? And that song reminded me of the young people that work in my office at Laurier. So I'm in a diversity and equity office, and one group in particular has been struggling. The Association of Black Students, over the course of the last few years, have watched nonstop the murder of people that look like them on social media, on the news. And while we gather to talk about it, these students are positioned as leaders in the institution, and they both have to hold their leadership and feel their feelings. And more, these leaders, Black youth that live right here in Waterloo, who live in Kitchener, who live in the Waterloo region, are coming to me and they're being very specific about what they need. They are asking for mental health support because the impact and the weight and the gravity of racism in our community is such that they need help. And that help is not available to them. And it reminded me of my role more personally as a mother. I'm raising three children. They identify as Black. They're living in our community where racism isn't the past. Racism is happening here. But don't you worry, because there's more to the song, and it gets better, because there's hope. Sehe, obata, sehe, yo, obara, hiya, serere. Sehe, obata, sehe, yo, obara, hiya, serere. That's actually the second part of the song, and there's something about it that I heard in my head while I was standing in front of these students that reminded me that every single one of us has a choice that we can make to bring inclusion here, within our sphere of influence. So personally, I've made a choice to go into the political arena, because what I've realized... I've made the choice because what I've realized is that we need to have people that look like me, that sound like me, that approach the world like me in those spaces. Because when the young people come into my office and they sit on the couch, I have a couch, feel free to come by, but they come, they sit on the couch, they're hurting and they're crying. One of the first things they say is that they can't even believe that they can find a Black woman that they can come to with their problems. And I'm hearing it from students, I'm hearing it from faculty, I'm hearing it from staff, and I'm hearing it from our own community. And so I've made that choice. But groups of people have worked with me to do other things. We released a report. It's